Hello there, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Lydia's Crafty Corner with me, Lydia, in my little crafty corner. So today I'm going to be sharing with you a super simple technique, again, using some watercolor brush markers, a little bit of spray water, and some doodling as well. So to start with, I am going to be using this super sweet stamp set, which is called Billowing Blossoms, and it has two florals and a little bush, as well as leaves and a center. I'm also going to be using the Spring Garden brush markers, a piece of watercolor cardstock, and a little mist sprayer. So to start with, as this is a new stamp set, I'm just going to be conditioning my stamps, and I'm just using an eraser on there. It doesn't have to be a special eraser, any eraser will do. The colors I'm using from the markers are Warm Sunshine, Ruby Light, and also some of that Deep Iris, Midnight Violet, as well. So I'm just going to colour on to my stamps. So this is one of the flower images, and I'm starting with the centre, and I'm just adding a little bit of that Warm Sunshine. I'm then going to take my Ruby Light, I'm going to add a little bit of this colour, and I'm then going to add the purple colour on there as well, which is the Midnight Violet. Now, as you can see, I'm not completely covering this images. You don't need to. And I do find that the less that you put on there, the better this is going to work out as well. So once I've done that, I'm then going to spray this with a little mini mister. This has just got plain, clean water in it. And I'm just adding a couple of squirts just to move that ink around. Now, when I stamp that down onto the paper, it's going to work out perfect. I'm then going to use moss and limeade for the leaf. So I have the leaf image onto my block. And I'm just going to add a little bit of that moss and then some of the limeade. Again, I haven't colored the whole of this image. I'm just going to spritz this to move the ink around and then stamp this into place onto that piece of watercolor cardstock that we have there. As you can see, I do dry off each of the stamps once I have finished stamping it down onto my cardstock, and then I do recolor. I do find that cleaning and keeping the image clear of water and before I colour on works a lot better. I did have a little bit of too much ink on my stamp that you can just see, and all I've done is taken a piece of tissue just to get rid of that. For the little little frond or blossom, I'm using some of the sea breeze and also a tiny bit of that Midnight Violet. Again, I haven't coloured the whole image, just little spritz and spots of colour, and then a little spritz of that water makes that that image really pop. So for the little stem, I'm just going to add a little bit using a little bit of direct to paper with the one of the watercolor markers. I did use some of the limeade for that. So I'm just going to keep going with the same technique for the flowers, for the leaves, and for that little bush, little blossom image, I should say. So as you can see, I do keep cleaning my stamps and making them nice and dry before I do add the colour. So for the flowers, again, I'm using that Warm Sunshine for the centre and little dips and drops of the beautiful Ruby Light and the Midnight Violet. For the little blossom piece that we have here, again, that's the Sea Breeze and the Midnight Violet, and a little bit of the green that I've just touched to the paper. Either the moss or the limeade would work for this. It's completely up to you how dark you want to go with it. I do find that adding these colours in tiny little amounts and then the water does give you enough there anyway. If you do find that you want a little bit more colour once you've added it to your cardstock, you can just add it in with your brush marker. Just adding a little bit of colour here and there will darken your images considerably. So as you can see, I'm just going to keep going until I've completed as much as I want on my piece of paper, on my watercolor cardstock, sorry. You could cover the whole of it if you wanted to, but I just wanted to keep my design to the bottom, and I do love how this looks. If you wanted to, you could just leave it as it is, but I am going to add a little bit extra to this. So I'm then going to take the center part from the stamp. This does come with the Billowing Blossom stamp set. And I'm just going to stamp the centres of these flowers in using some of that obsidian ink. You don't have to do this if you don't want to. You could keep it nice and soft with just the spritzed watercolour. But I wanted to add a little bit more contrast with mine. I'm then going to add a little bit more detail to these images using a little bit of doodling. I just have a black fine line pen, And I'm just going to go over. Now, you do need to make sure that your images are nice and dry before you do add any of a fine line pen, because this one that I am using is water-based, so it would have bled into the image, and I didn't want that. I wanted nice, crisp lines. Also, when doodling, I do find that it looks better when you do it a lot quicker, so you're not really thinking about the image, you're just adding a little bit of doodling, which looks very, very pretty. Once I finish my doodling, I'm then going to add my panel onto a piece of my card base, sorry, and I'm just using some tape because I've used watercolor card, so it has buckled a little bit. For my sentiment, I'm using the Label Love stamp set, and I'm just going to stamp this onto a piece of solar white cardstock using the Obsidian ink. I did dry this using my heat tool, so it dried nice and quickly, and I'm then going to trim around this using some scissors. You could trim right up to the edge if you wanted to, but I do like having that little bit of a white edge around it. I do find that it makes the sentiment pop a little bit more. So once I have finished trimming that, I'm going to add a little bit of foam tape behind it before I do add it on into place onto my card base. So here is the card complete. I really do hope that you've enjoyed the video and that you like the technique and that you do give it a go as well. It would be great if you do and you do share it, because we love to see your projects as well. Again, everyone, thank you so much for watching. If you do want to watch any more videos, there's a couple more here that you can watch at your own leisure. Also, if you don't want to miss out on any videos that we do upload to the channel, it'd be great if you do subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Have a great day. See you really soon. Bye-bye.